Are we good? I think so. Cool. Okay. Hello, it's been a while. A variety of reasons between laziness and mental health problems, so what can you do? But I decided that I wanted to do another tutorial of Christy Partridge's because I still don't feel confident enough to do this on my own. And just getting back into it, wanted a little bit of guidance. So I have everything set up already. I've actually already done, you can kind of tell on here that there's masking fluid, which it feels like latex when it dries, so it's kind of hard to tell if it's totally dry or not. I think it actually is. It just feels a little tacky, maybe, but I think it's good enough. So I'm gonna go ahead and start. Oh, you know what I didn't do is put a photo up for this one. Let me do that real quick. I'm a little nervous about this one. I feel like most of the other ones feel very straightforward, as much as her stuff is straightforward, since she does very loose interpretations. Loose in her terms, she calls it loose watercoloring. But I'm a little apprehensive with this one because it doesn't feel that way to me, but maybe going through it'll feel better. We'll see. Actually, kind of confused as to why I didn't have this stuff in here already, but again, what you gonna do? Hey, Chindo. Okay, there's that one, and then let me grab a clip of what it should sort of look like at the end. I'm actually gonna move this like right here. Cause it's kinda small, but you can get the idea. Yeah, good enough. So, without further ado, let's attempt to do this thing. How is the music level, Jindo? Is it too loud? Do I need to turn it down some? I spill water all over my leg. So I think we're going to be starting with the background first. Should probably do this with the fan pointing away from me, but details. Let's also open these up. So I'm going to be following what she does, but she does also experiment with the color scheme. The original photo is very like orangey and yellowy, and she does a lot more like purples and blues. So I'm going to be following along with what she does, and I believe that entails with some experimentation. So let's see. I think we're gonna start with this brighter blue. Yeah. Ugh, I have cat hair in my paint trays. Hey, Sasha. See, at least when you're a computer nerd, you always have canned air nearby. Oh man, it's been a while. I am so not confident in my ability to do this. Yes. Yeah, so there's masking fluid all over it. So... Yeah. All right, so she has hers a little more aquamarine-y, I guess, which how do I do that? I guess I can add like a Scotia lime. A Scotia lime. We'll see how that works. Oh, that was way too much. That was way more than a Scotia, Aaron. That was at least 10 Scotias. All right, let's try to fix that. Okay, closer, but... man, Carrie Fisher is friggin' amazing, too. That is good advice. And, I mean, technically I am, so... Yay. All right. That is absolutely not the blue at all that I want, so I'm just gonna start over. I don't actually think I have a way to make the blue that she has. She has a really incredibly bright blue. So we're just gonna work with what I have. Yeah, and go from there. Apprehension. Oh, you know what? One trick that I learned to do, because like I don't want to play her sound, but I can put on the captions. So, oh, she's actually talking about how you can use any blue that you want. So, yay! Did she pre-wet? Hold on. I gotta see if she pre-wet this. I don't actually think she did, which is weird because she usually does for her backgrounds. That's actually not the source Teldrack. That's the final product. Ideally, she does not pre-wet that at all. All right. It really feels like this should be wet already, though. All Did she really not pre-wed this? Work on it in sections. She's doing a wet and wet method. All right. I think that this should be wet. She doesn't actually show doing it, but I'm fairly certain that this should be wet, so. Maybe she doesn't. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. She didn't do it, but I feel like I should. Nice, Keldrak. What you working on? The business site. Okay, she's starting in with her Payne's Gray. I swear to God, I need to get that at some point. You're not talking about Ronnie's place, right?
Oh, cool.
So I need to swap to doing a purple. She's like, "Oh, by the way, you're gonna want to do this really quickly." I'm like, "Ah! Am I now? You don't say." Aw, fudge, I messed that up. I put my dirty brush in the clean water. Tragedy strikes. Well, on the bright side, I feel like the bubbling of the paper is actually helping me out a little bit here, so I guess that's good. Aw, thanks guys. I can't see what it looks like to you guys right now because I have the tutorial up on top of that. I can only see what you guys are chatting, but good to know. Yeah, Jindo, I think regarding the wetting, I actually didn't need to do it. So it is technically wet and wet, but she's actually using the paint as the wet, which sounds weird. Is this the purple I want? Yes, okay, good. So I think it would have been okay either way. I do have a little bit too much water on my paper right now, which is something I always struggle with. I don't know why I haven't quite diagnosed that yet, but that's a thing. And it looks like she actually brings the dark like all the way to the edge, which I messed up. So let's see if I can smooth that out a little bit. I think that looks better. It might. You're right. She wants stronger purples with less water throughout the bottom. I'm just assuming that's what she sounds like. I can't actually hear her right now. Okay, yeah. I actually sort of accidentally already did that, so go me. Black, eh? You're so adventurous, Kirsty. That is true. They do dry. She's talking about how watercolors dry lighter than they look on paper, which is another thing that I often forget. So basically she's saying it's okay to be bold, Aaron. It's fine. Don't worry so much. See, this pool right here is problematic. We'll work through it. That just looks kind of blocky to me, so I'm hoping that putting water on top of it will help it disperse. I'm digging the clarinet. It's really good. Actually makes me think of like Wild Arms or something with the harmonica. So she's doing this technique now where she's just adding clean water onto it to give it like a little star effect. So we'll try. Yeah, it's pretty cool. I think I added a little too much water, but whatever, it's fine. All right, so I think she's gonna continue doing like this side of it now. So go back to our lot of blue. She doing this with a bigger brush again? Yeah, that's fine. I'll just do it with this one. Okay, so now Basically, and go over that and start doing looks like some shading for it with just like a darker version, which basically means more pigment. And then, sometimes I wonder a lot of what she does if it's like really well intentioned with a purpose, which I assume so because her stuff always looks friggin' amazing. But then other times I'm like, is she just doing this randomly? And she's just like, yeah, this will look good. Like, I don't know. Swapping over. I think towards this one. We'll try it and see how it goes. I think, yeah, the randomness is definitely something that adds to a unique factor, especially in watercolor. And yeah, I feel like watercolor is not just like a happy mistake, it's literally a bunch of intentional happy mistakes. Like I've said before, watercolor is the herding cats of art. You just kind of hope that it does what you want it to. So I'm gonna add a little more of this in, and then I'm gonna start doing like the purples and blacks and stuff that I have over here. I didn't literally mean from over there, but there's just so much pooled up right here that I'm just gonna steal some of that. Watercolor makes you think of omelets? How does it make you think of omelets? It does not make me think of omelets or pancakes. I'm sorry, Jindo. And I think your brain is more creative than mine. Me see what this looks like to you guys. Oh, interesting. Okay. Interesting that looking at it on camera makes me see things that I wanted to go do and forgot. Wonder if I can get away with it like this. I like how those ones turned out better. I think it's because there's less water already in the paper. Even the resulting fluffiness is making more sense. Right, what are we doing now? I don't understand. Maybe. I'm not going to, though. I'll leave them how they are. Ponyo, I mean, that makes more sense since at least it's like a sea creature type thing. Ponyo is one of the only Miyazaki movies I do not like. I did not enjoy it at all. I'm usually fine with weird, I just didn't enjoy it. I'm not quite sure why. I just remember not liking it. I watched it like right when it first came out and I didn't like it, and so I didn't bother ever going back and trying it again. It's possible that I might like it, you know, nowadays, but yeah, I just have no interest really in attempting to reconcile that relationship. You didn't foreshadow it at all? Like, you couldn't predict what was going to happen? Okay, she's already at the salt sprinkling stage, and I actually think I am going to go ahead and do that too. So. Although I feel like the top's already really dried, but that's fine. I have the AC really cranked in here because it's friggin' hot today. I was actually only able to mow my front yard because I couldn't handle doing the back too. I was too tired. Got a little bit of everywhere. Excuse me, salt. Excuse me, salt. My hands feel really gross after that. Fails everywhere. I just tried to put lotion in my hand and it just squirted out onto my desk instead. But the most foreign. Huh. Like, I like obscure plots, even ones that kind of don't make sense, but I don't know. I don't know. Like I said, I haven't bothered to go back and watch it since it came out, and it came out like, what, 20 years? Not 20, maybe 10 years ago. I have no concept of time. Okay, so it looks like I got to mix up some pink. Oh, it actually is working on the top of the picture. Cool. I thought that I didn't have it. It was too dry already, but apparently not. Yay. All right, so I'm supposed to be doing a very light pink, which we'll see about that. Let's try this one. Think that could work. With a lot of water. A lot of water. Growing out my bangs is such a pain in the butt. Oops. My bad. I accidentally brushed the background there and brought it up into the hood. That sucks. Fine, it'll just add a little bit of character. I don't know why this color is especially easy to pick up a lot of pigment for. Like, it seems just very, I guess, bright in comparison to a lot of the colors. Saturated? Saturated is a better word. Not quite what I'm wanting it to do, but whatever. Thought Remy was just staring at me disturbingly, you know, like he does. But he wasn't, he was staring at the wall. Yeah, it's a watercolor is a whole different beast. Like, honestly, sometimes I feel like the only reason that I can do it is because it is so just random feeling. Like, there is a bit of skill that goes into knowing how to control it. But I still feel like it's one of those things where you just gotta hope for the best sometimes. So when she does her lines, they don't have these little like splotchy thingies at the end, and I'm not entirely sure how to not get those. It's what it is I'm doing wrong with that. I hope so. I hope so, Sasha. I am not feeling great about it right now, but you know, I never do, so. You're just going to point out that I never feel like it's looking good. Yeah, so I was just adding in a tiny bit of a highlight right there to attempt to help define the edge of the jellyfish. Okay, and then she's doing her little water blob trick again on there. Which I'm gonna do with a smaller brush this time, although she's going ham on these. does look pretty darn cool, though. Thanks, Sasha. Alright, so let me actually use this boy. You know, I was thinking about you when I picked the jellyfish, because I know you like cuttlefish a lot, so. Okay, so I'm actually going to use, my two for this. So she's actually going in and adding in even darker, like blues and blacks in the background area behind the jellyfish. She was using a larger brush for this to kind of help it blend better, though. So let me swap. Poster Google is a full print that goes for $80. Oh, cool! That's amazing. What was the print of? And of course, I think of you. She's doing some splatters. Okay, hold on. I actually think I'm gonna go in with a little more water on the hood of the jellyfish. So it's like completely bled in there, which it's not really supposed to have. I think I am going to attempt to rectify that a little bit, because those blues were not supposed to pull up into the hood like that. Not quite so dramatically, at least. Just fix that a bit. It'll be fine. I'm trying to get angles where the light's not shining on it so much. Try and pull that highlight back. I think so. What does that look like to you guys? It's a little more defined. Not a whole lot, but a little bit. I think that helped a bit. All right. I just stuck my arm in this paint. Right, we were doing splatters. All right. What's next? Okay, so we're doing arms next. Too much purple. No, there was really too much purple in this. I had to dial it back a little. I played video games. My family didn't want to do anything, so I stayed in and yeah. But the video games were fun and I had good company for them, so you know. How about you? Did you go see fireworks? Was there anywhere that was actually having fireworks? Yeah, I actually brought the cats up into the room. I locked them in here with me. Normally, I don't do that, although they are locked in here with me right now. But yeah, Remy was beside himself. He hates fireworks. Guile was nervous, but he calmed down after a little while. I managed to play with him a little bit, and he settled down. So, but Remy actually wedged himself underneath the couch, which is pretty impressive. There's not a whole lot of room. And he is not a tiny cat. Remy definitely can be when he wants to be. That is true. Oh, wait a second. We're putting orange in now? You need to give me a heads up on these things, Kirsty. Hold up. Hold up. She likes to try and catch me off guard like that. She does a pretty good job of it usually too. She's just like, what's something unexpected we could throw at Aaron? Orange. Are you being serious, Sasha? I don't feel like my technique is excellent at all. If you say so, I. If you say so, Sasha. You know that picture of that chemistry dog where it's like, I have no idea what I'm doing? That is me. Nerdbird Da Vinci. I'm glad you're liking it. I'm really enjoying the colors because from the I'll show you the reference photo afterwards. But it's very like just monotone. It's not even monotone. It's not monotone, but like it definitely doesn't pop like this. So. Oh, she did actually add that into the water too. Okay. Not, I shouldn't be surprised. This is Kirsty we're talking about. Oh crap, she like, I look down, she already did the other two arms. Liking these tunes. Oh, she is doing that. Okay, good. Like, yes, I'm gonna make the executive decision. Oh, you did too. Okay, I feel better now. Let's check in with Kirsty. It's interesting because it feels like we've got most everything in place. However, I'm not even halfway done with her tutorial. So, my guess is she's actually going to let this whole thing dry, and this is going to be the base, and then she's actually going to go back in and add more details, is what my guess is going to be. So, hold on, let me. Let me watch for a second here since I haven't been paying attention to our girl. Okay. I think I was right. So, I think I'm gonna add a little more purple in here, and then she says she sprinkled everything with salt again and then lets everything dry. So I think, unfortunately, I'm gonna probably end the stream there. I thought that would take a little bit longer, but I guess it's been an hour and 40-ish minutes. So, I'm just gonna finish adding a little more pizzazz over here. And then, yeah, I have to let everything dry anyway, so I guess I'll do that in a part two, because I have a couple other things that I gotta get done today anyway. So, thank you guys for hanging out with me while I'm doing this and encouraging me to paint more. I really appreciate that. Especially you, Teldrak. Like, I blame this whole thing on you. This will be good too, because I can reset my palette and everything, because it's going to be a pretty hot mess here. But yeah, so I think part two will be going in and actually adding all the details that really kind of help it come together. You can actually already see a lot of the effect that the salt is having, which is kind of cool. Ugh, I hate how it feels though. Have you painted before, Jindo? Are you have you done any sort of like acrylic or anything? Look at this hot mess. Look at this hot mess. It's actually not as bad as it usually is. I'm going to move my actual paint set where the cats can't get it so it can properly dry because I don't think I let it last time. It still seemed a little gooey. Exactly, Velocidotis. But yeah, I will probably before I actually start streaming again next time too, I'm just gonna go ahead and get all of the masking tape off because I think she takes it off. Obviously, if she doesn't, I won't. But it's a pain and it's not really fun for me, and I highly doubt it won't be fun to watch. So I'll do that in between too, and get all the salt off because ew, ew. Saltwater painting, pretty much. Obsessed with this painting of the sun. A painting that you did or that somebody else did? Shout out Teletubbies. Teldrak. Oh, cool. Did you give it away? Oh, can you tell the difference in the quality of this video feed here? I feel like it's pretty significant, personally. It feels a lot more high def. Sasha, I guess you're probably the only one that would actually have a good opinion on that. I mean, I only have like a tiny little screen that I'm watching like this on. Okay. So it's not super obvious. Well, that's unfortunate. I was hoping it was significantly better. Yeah, so it used to be at 780p and now it's at 1920. I mean, it's zoomed in, so technically it's less, but I feel like it's significantly better. But I'm gonna be bummed if I bought an extra webcam. Ah. Portrait mode? Like vertical? Okay. Well, hopefully the quality is better. I'm gonna pretend like it is. Oh yeah, just wait till it dries completely, Jindo. It's like a whole different thing. That's why when you're painting it, you really have to kind of like anticipate what it's going to look like. Because it's so drastically different afterwards. Especially if you do stuff like you can do techniques obviously with salt or you can do stuff with Saran wrap too. Which I am not very good at the Saran wrap stuff. I always mess it up somehow. But you can kind of get like a snowflakey looking effect, which is kind of cool. But another thing to note is that when I did the masking, so like all of the stuff that's keeping the paint from going onto the paper, she used a pen, which I don't have. So I had to actually use a paintbrush, so my lines are not quite as fine as hers, which is a little unfortunate, but I think it'll be okay. We'll just have a chunkier looking jellyfish. So that might be the actual stream. Hey, Gob. I'm just wrapping up. Sasha, so that might be the actual stream, because I think you can only stream at 1080. But this feed here, this one, is 1920. So the camera is pulling it in at 1920. So maybe it looks different to me because I'm seeing it in its original format resolution. The original resolution. But the actual stream that it outputs at is less. So I don't know. Yeah, sorry, Gabo. I'm going to have to do a part two for this, so I can try and give you a heads up when I do that. It'll probably be in the next few days because I hate having this just sitting here because I'm afraid something's going to happen to it. So I'll probably try and do that Monday or Tuesday. Yeah, sure thing. Yeah, so this is kind of like the underlying work portion here. My notion is that we're going to have to go back in and add a lot more details because this, I mean, watercolor is always a little bit blurry. But oh, thank you. That's nice. I feel like a potato, but I have plans to go back onto my diet soon, but I'm trying to get up enough mental health currency to be able to handle doing that because right now I don't have it. So this is part of that process, trying to get back to doing those things. So. Do you guys want to say hi to the kitties before I end stream? Either way, I want them to say hi to you, so hold on. Remster! Ha, handsome. Hi, you want to say hi? You say hi? Yeah? Come on. You are first victim.
Say hi to Remy. You say hi. Oh, thank you for kisses, baby. Thank you. You're so sweet. Oh, you're just sweetie.
He's just thankful that I protected him from the fireworks, the terrifying fireworks.
You want to see a painting? What do you think? What do you think? Do we have your approval?
Does it smell funny?
Does he smell funny?
Thank you, baby. Those are very nice kisses. Please don't end in bites. That's often how it goes. Is he'll be like, oh, I love you, I love you. Chomp! He's actually in a very chill mood right now. Normally he'd be a little more skittish, but... Okay. Thank you, Sasha. Alright, it looks like Gail's getting jealous and wants to say hi too, so let me put down Remy.
Say bye-bye. We say bye-bye. Say bye-bye.
Thank you for kisses, baby. You should joke, boy. Alright, where's your brother at?
Go, baby. Hi, cutie. Oh, did you just wake up from a nap? Big stretch. Come say hi to everybody.
It's so funny picking up Guile after holding Remy. Guile is, he feels like he's half the weight. He's not, but he feels like it.
Okay. Okay. Here we go. Okay, hi. Say hello. Hello.
I'm tickling his belly. He's like, damn it, Mom.
Okay, okay.
I could. I don't know how many people would be interested in of that, but I could definitely do that. At the very least, I could just do like a quick video or something. Oh, they would get tuckered out after an hour. I used to have a kitten cam while I was playing Overwatch, because Remy used to play and like lay down right next to me while I was playing, but he doesn't do that anymore, so. Apparently, Guile is happy with these chin scratches, though.
Yeah? Do you want to see the photo? What is on my hand? Is that dirt from one of you? Yes. Want to see the photo? What do you think? What do you think?
Not so sure? You just want to get down, don't you?
Okay. We say bye. We're just saying bye, and then I'll put you down. Look, look, I say bye-bye. Say bye-bye.
He's like, just put me down, please. Okay. Okay. Mess with the mew, you get the pew-pew. I like that. Yeah, it's funny because usually Guile is more chill and, Remy is like the tense, anxious one, but yeah, apparently right now Remy is in super chill mode. So, yeah. Anyways, alright, well, I gotta go get to doing chores and stuff. Thank you again for hanging out with me. I really appreciate it, you guys. So, bye.